It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in one bathroom. That have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work at cleaning up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the
Fantastic.
Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. I noticed that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families. Those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in one bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they give me the news, and I start crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Mm-hmm. On Saturdays,
the Fantastic. Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. I noticed that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love. from other people to my family, it made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living is not, it does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make a difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me too. Be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. That have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
On Saturdays,
the oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. Remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people. To my family, it made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only 1 bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a 1 bedroom apartment with 7 people living. I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, we the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, and 1 bathroom. I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady, some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a more better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the
Fantastic.
Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. Remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made a difference for my kids, and it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only 1 bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a 1-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in one bathroom. I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Mm-hmm. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they give me the news, and I start crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work at cleaning up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, and then in the afternoon, you were working on your habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families. Those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make a difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So, as a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they give me the news, and I start crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a more better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
On Saturdays,
the Fantastic. Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. I remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family, it made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living is not, it does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Help you on Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the Fantastic. Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. I noticed that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made a difference for my kids, and it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and seven in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with seven people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a more better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the
Fantastic.
Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. I remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people. To my family, it made a difference for my kids, and it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only 1 bathroom, and 7 in the family, and I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living is not it does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with seven people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a more better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work at
so
cleaning up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the
Fantastic.
Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. Remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people. To my family, it made a difference for my kids, and it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only 1 bathroom, and 7 in the family, and I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a 1-bedroom apartment with 7 people living. I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give. give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, and that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, and 1 bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady, some ladies here, for, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the
Fantastic.
Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. Remember that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made a difference for my kids, and it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only 1 bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a 1-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I. It really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
Thank you.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we are starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make the difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico,
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in 1 bathroom. I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Mm-hmm. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they give me the news, and I start crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work at picking up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Helped you on mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the Fantastic. Oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. I noticed that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families. Those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family. It made the difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, and 7 in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with 7 people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
It's not a giveaway. It's you work for this. And that's core values that are not only instilled in the program, but in our country. So I think you're just contributing to a better society.
It was just great to be a part of that as well. You know, it's like, in a sense, we're starting a new life for ourselves.
We don't believe in handouts. Each one of us, through my parents' values, we believe in sweat equity. We believe in the value of hard work.
Thanks to Habitat and the volunteers, it really set the foundation for us to really take advantage of opportunities and really succeed.
So I think it was a huge part of who we are and how it shaped us, especially the whole sense of giving back.
I can never pay God for those blessings. All I can do is pay it back and wish that my kids can make a difference and serve others as you guys have served us. So may God bless you and continue to pass it on to other families.
My name is Carol Friend, and I grew up in California and moved out here as a teenager to Rapid City. Callan is 7 years old, and Savannah is 5 years old. She loves her stuffed animals. He has a fascination with trains and trucks and airplanes. Moving and going through a divorce, and then my dad came down with cancer. And so he lived in Wyoming and he needed my help. And so I did everything I could to care for him in the midst of bringing my homework to the hospital and the little ones. I was at church. I mean, when all of this was going on, I didn't know where else to turn. Owning a home, you can look forward to the payments going away someday, as opposed to the payments for rent continuously increasing. I went to the library, to the class, and filled out the application, and I thought, what have I got to lose? It felt like it was an answer to my prayers that I had been praying and praying and praying over and over and over, that God would please help me with a stable home environment. I just can't express enough how much this means to me to be able to go forward with owning a home and providing a stable environment, especially for my kids, especially when I have something to compare it to with moving around so much. And it just means a lot. It really, really, truly means a lot.
Hi, Maria. How are you?
My parents, when I graduated from high school in Mexico.
I was going through divorce, that was a scary moment in my life, not knowing what I was going to do with my 5 children. And we used to live by Pactola Lake in a mobile home with 3 bedrooms, small bedrooms, in one bathroom. That I have a lot of support from my church. Somebody from my church helped me actually work for Habitat as a volunteer, so he helped me fill out the application. I moved in 1996. It took 1 year for them to build it. So. As a single mom, I knew through counseling, you know, the dangers of children, you know, raised with one parent. Right. So I promised to myself that I always was going to try to be there for my children. Mm-hmm. It was hard, you know. Sometimes you have fears as a single parent, but I also have faith, my faith, and that God, as long as I trust in Him, He was going to be with me and my children. Dinner was ready, and somebody knocked on the door and said, "Mom, there is a lady. Some ladies here, you know, wants to see you." So I went outside and I saw 2 ladies. One I recognized from my church also, and they have balloons. And so then they gave me the news, and I started crying. That was the joy and a blessing, because I knew the importance to have a better home for my kids. After I cleaned my house, I came a little bit here to do something. And then on Saturdays, I brought my older kids because they did not let the little ones. They came to work to clean up the yard.
You were cleaning homes during the day, mm-hmm. and then in the afternoon, you were working on your Habitat home.
Yeah, I did not go up the hill because I live at Pactola Lake.
Yeah.
So I finished my house, and I came to at least do 2 hours helping the crew here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then your children also
on Saturdays.
Mm-hmm. Saturdays.
On Saturdays, the oldest.
What is your favorite part about your home here?
My favorite part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everything. Mm-hmm. Memories that this home left me with my kids, thanks to those families, those people who help. And that's my favorite part, that this house was made with love from other people to my family, it made a difference for my kids. And it's still making the difference.
We used to live in a mobile home with only one bathroom, seven in the family. And I desired to have a better opportunity to provide them with something better.
The cost of living is not, it does not match what people are making. Living in a one-bedroom apartment with seven people living in there, I think that's unjust.
I saw that it really brought a lot of joy to my mom, and then more so to my siblings and I, it really brought on a lot of opportunity.
My other siblings and I, you know, the work that we're doing is helping others. We saw how people came to help my family, and I think it just fostered that in our lives, that desire to help people in need as well.
You're not only helping fund a house, you're helping create citizens, you're helping build a community.
Definitely give, give freely. We're just one of many families who have found themselves in need.
Thank you.